Thanks so much for coming. I'm so excited to be here. Let's see if this works. Yes. So my name is Niamh. I'm a physicist. In 2014, I graduated from UCC with a degree in physics. That's a picture of me and my family. My mom and dad are here today. Thanks for the shout out, mom. And I started my PhD in October 2014. My research is in the area of optical communications. So what's that all about? Information on the internet travels through optical fibers. Optical fibers are basically really long strands of very pure glass, and the internet is basically just a bunch of computers talking to each other. So those computers talk to each other in a language of ones and zeros. And we send this down the optical fiber by translating those ones and zeros into pulses of light. Turn a laser on for one, turn it off for zero. Similar enough to Morse code. And then this laser light bounces down the optical fiber and travels around the world. And this is basically what connects countries and continents, and it's why we can send messages to the other side of the globe almost instantaneously. So my PhD, I'm trying to build a new type of optical communication system that's going to be based on optical fibers that are hollow rather than solid. Why are we bothering doing this? We're going to do this because these fibers could carry much more information faster than ever before. But to do this, we have to use new types of lasers and amplifiers and transmitters and receivers, all these new things. And what I'm trying to do is take all of these together and build it into an optical communication system that's competitive with those that currently exist. So that's what my PhD research is about. And the other aspect of my job is science communication. So fairly on, early on into my PhD, I started getting involved in research activities, started going into schools, doing lab tours, and taking part in science communication competitions. It was something that I felt really passionate about because when I was in school, I didn't see any female physicists, so I wanted to go out into schools and show other girls that there are female physicists out there. And actually, almost 2 years ago, exactly here on this stage, I won the FAMELAB final. So I was thinking, when I came back into this room, I almost got like PTSD. I got so much nerves. I was so nervous going into that. But I was so excited coming in here today. And this was amazing, an amazing opportunity for me, and gave me such a platform to keep communicating science. And it naturally segued for me into talking about diversity in science and the lack of women in physics, for example, and to talk about other things that I'm passionate about. But at this time, or during this time, when I was discovering my voice as a researcher and my voice as a communicator, I was pretty much silent about other aspects of my life. So during 2015, in the first year of my PhD, we had the marriage equality referendum here in Ireland. And that was a tricky time for me in my life, because while I disagreed with everything that the no side was saying, I also, as a bisexual woman, felt excluded from the yes campaign, because everything in their literature was referring to the fact that this mattered to gay people and lesbians and their families. And the last thing I wanted to do was jeopardize that campaign in any way. So I just stayed silent, and I worked on the campaign feeling more like an ally rather than part of the community. Lucky enough, it passed, so you know, it was all celebration and we're happy about it now, but it was quite a tricky time for me. I wanted to come out during that time, but I think I couldn't really articulate why it mattered to me, because what was the point of coming out? I didn't know who I was going to end up with. You know, why make a big fuss about it? So I decided not to say anything. But then, nearly a year later exactly, a few months after FAMELAB had happened, I was in the second year of my PhD, and the shooting happened at the Pulse nightclub in Orlando. And this affected me, even though it was on the other side of the world, this affected me greatly. one of the things that really stuck with me at the time was one of the reports from the EMT people who went into the club in the aftermath of the shooting and said that it was completely silent apart from the sound of people's phones ringing from, it still says me. People's phones ringing and their loved ones calling them, knowing that they'll never come home. And I was just done at that point. I was just done pretending that this wasn't a part, that I wasn't a part of this community and this community wasn't a part of me. So during that summer then, following that happened in June, I came out to my family and it all went really well. They were really supportive. They didn't care as long as they were happy and healthy. Everything was grand. So that was over that summer. And then just for anyone that I didn't get around to, in September for 5 weeks of the day, I put up a status on Facebook as well. And I quickly realized that coming out is not something that you do only once, especially for bisexual people who are always assumed you're either one side or the other, you're gay or straight, nothing in between. It's something that you have to do again and again and again. And I think this was tricky for me at the time. Oh, some of my stuff is covered there, but that's okay. This was tricky for me at the time because I was very lucky to have a lovely partner whose name is Mike, and he's still my partner. It was his 30th birthday yesterday. Yay! So I think people were a bit like, oh, but you have a boyfriend though. Like, oh, I don't think you understand the fundamental aspect of this. So it was, you know, it was a lot of conversations, but it was good. I was literally raising awareness within my own circles. And I got involved in groups such as Bi Ireland, which are an Irish group for bisexual people. And I began to realize the need for bi-specific services within our community as well. Some of the stats are hidden behind that picture there. There were supposed to be animations on this. But they just say that bisexual women are more likely to suffer from things like anxiety and depression in comparison to lesbian and heterosexual women. A half of bisexual women report domestic violence in comparison to a third of lesbians and a quarter of heterosexual women. And really speaking to my own experience of never feeling at home with the gays and at home with the straights, a 2015 survey found that there was nearly identical prejudice towards bisexual people from heterosexual people and from homosexual people. So we're kind of caught in the middle there. And it really opened my eyes as to the need to be visible and to really advocate for my community. So I also, during this time, realized that while we had marriage equality and while you can no longer be fired for being gay, this didn't necessarily translate into being included in the workplace. So 2 years after the marriage equality referendum, I wrote an article for the Irish Research Council about why LGBT inclusion is so important in the workplace. Because most employees spend nearly a quarter of their hours in the week at work, and no one should feel free to be themselves in that time. And the mental stress of constantly having to cover up the stigmatized sexuality has been shown to be linked to high levels of stress, anxiety, and depression. So I wrote about that in that article. And it was during researching for that article that I actually realized that things are worse in STEM in comparison to other fields. So LGBT staff and students in STEM are more likely than those in other fields to report things such as fear, harassment, and even physical violence on campus. So reading into this, it really just spurred me into action. And with the support of my supervisor, Fatima, she's brilliant, she's amazing, we set up a local LGBT employee resource group in Tyndall, where I work. That took a long time to get up and running. And it was during that time that I took part in the March for Science in Ireland. And that's where I met the brilliant Sean O'Boyle. And we got to talking, long story short, and then he brought this idea to me about setting up a network in Ireland, which I thought was amazing and absolutely wanted to be a part of. So that's my story. And there is a lot of points in my early PhD, or even just in physics in general, where as a woman I felt quite alone. There wasn't a lot of us around. But as a queer woman, I felt completely alone. I didn't see anyone else like me around, and I really didn't feel like I fit in. So my hope for networks like this is just to show people like me that they're not alone, and that there is a home for them in science. So I just want to say thank you so much for letting me come up and say this story. There's no way in 2014 that I would have imagined that I would have been standing on a stage talking so openly about this. It's amazing. So thank you for giving me the opportunity. Thank you for my today. And thank you especially to my family who supports me every step of the way.